The health and well-being of individuals and communities are shaped by the social, economic, and physical environments in which we live. Factors such as housing, education, employment, and social support can influence health outcomes of young people. Sometimes these are referred to as the social determinants of health. Social inequalities are associated with increased risk of mental health disorders. For example, unemployment, precarious employment, and poor employment conditions are linked to increased psychological stress. Young people are particularly likely to experience unemployment and underemployment. In Australia, the mental well-being of cultural minority groups may be impacted by past and ongoing social inequalities. For Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples, intergenerational trauma linked to events arising from colonialism, including loss of land, the stolen generation, separation from culture and identity, and racism contribute to ongoing disadvantage. This continues to impact the social, emotional, and spiritual well-being of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander youth today. For these reasons, it's critical that research is conducted in genuine partnership with communities and is done in an informed and culturally safe way. So what is important for researchers to consider? A multitude of factors contribute to an individual's health and well-being. Therefore, it is important to understand which social determinants are most relevant for the young people involved in your research, and assess whether interventions should address multiple social determinants. Social determinants also change over time, so research considering social determinants should embrace a whole-of-life approach. You may want to consider the stages of life that young people will move through, and how addressing social determinants might improve prevention and early intervention and contribute to long-term outcomes. It is important to understand the impacts of intergenerational trauma on mental health and well-being among Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander youth. You should consider whether your research is culturally appropriate, if it strengthens cultural connectedness and identity, and whether it centres the voices of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, including youth, researchers, and in leadership. It is also important to view the health and well-being of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander youth in a holistic context that considers the mental, physical, cultural, and spiritual health of the individual and the whole community. Listening to, consulting, and co-designing research with community is critical in addressing the social determinants of mental health. To learn more, visit the Matilda Centre website.